Seems everybody's into the green that I paint my machines with, so I'm going to paint this one as well. The color I'm using is a CIL Calypso Green, and it's just ordinary indoor paint. I'll use my spray gun for that. I think that needs a little bit of water added to it. So this is now with two coats of the house paint on there. I had to thin it down a little bit and it was a bit sputtery, but it worked okay. And what I like to do is to protect that paint and give it a bit of a gloss is I like to put a clear coat on there, just essentially a clear varnish. For the top of the saw, I rubbed some black acrylic paint onto it just for contrast, and I taped up the slot so I wouldn't get any finish in there, and I'm going to try this Fuse UV finish, but before I put that finish on, it needs a special primer to get really good adhesion. So I'm going to finish the top of this with this Fuse UV cured finish. And it comes in these cans, it's quite thick, so it needs to be thinned with a little bit of acetone. Otherwise, it makes for a far too thick a coat. So this is a UV cured finish. It's also quite smelly. So it's best to use it outside on a bright day, so then you can use the sun to UV cure it. With the first coat now fully cured in the sun, I'm just using a scraper to take out all the high spots, because everywhere there's a fiber sticking out, there will be a bump in the finish. Now with this finish fully sun cured and scraped flat, hopefully the next coat is going to come out nice and smooth. But with these UV finishes, you typically end up buffing it afterwards, and I don't have a buffing wheel. We'll see what happens.
I was kind of running out of daylight after that second coat, so I had to move it a few times to catch those last rays of sun.
Well, that finish didn't come out the smoothest, but it's nice and hard, and it's shiny.
And with the rest of the saw painted and varnished, the fence looked out of place, so I did that one as well.
I quite like how this saw looks without that cloth in the front, but I put it back to help keep the dust inside. I attached that cloth with some screws and washer now, so I wouldn't have to use up two of my spring clamps to hold it. And if I want to use it with some sort of shop vac or dust collector, I just stick the hose in the front, and that's that.